Fiat's test track in La Mandre, near Turin. The pilot is the chief test pilot of ABAF, Giorgio Pianta. It's autumn 1984. The car livery is yet to be seen on the shell of the newborn Lancer. They're the first tests of Fiat's response to Peugeot and Audi. The manufacturer from Turin is getting ready for a jump forward in search of new technical solutions.
The engine had been designed by Claudio Lombardi. It was a four-cylinder aluminium engine, 1,750 cc's, and it had a lot of bottom-end power, which was a good invention, and a lot of top-end power with twin turbochargers. It had a Volumex compressor, and that allowed right in the low rev range to come out of the corners at low speed with a lot of power. And it had a lot of torque, very high torque indeed. And then at high revs, where the volumetric compressor was unable to give the right turbo pressure to give the top levels of power, with a sophisticated pneumatic control system, the turbo compressor produced 3 bar of pressure and gave power outputs that were around and in excess of 500 horsepower. There was, however, too much pressure in the intake manifolds, so a valve opened, which allowed this excessive pressure of the manifolds to go out. And that was the classic whistling sound that the S4 was famous for. It seemed like a bit of a sneezed whistle, and in fact, even when you couldn't see the car, the fans in the special stages recognized it for this particular noise.